I have an interesting and unusual idea for a project and an experiment. The design is very simple and curious, and is applicable not only here, but also in many other areas. Hello, friends. I'll start right away with the basics. The body will be a round tube, although it may be square or rectangular. You need to make a hole in it for the exit of gases. There will also be a pipe, but of a smaller diameter. Instead of angle grinders, I use plasma, although not so neatly, but quickly. Without a template, it is difficult to keep the plasma cutter straight. Look what they sent me from AliExpress. It's a small electric automotive turbine. I'm using her today. Automotive turbine already comes with a regulator and controller. She works on 12 volts, and then as a power source there will temporarily be a battery from screwdriver. She's so powerful that it raises himself. In a word, turbine! I bought a cone pipe in a store. She will serve to narrow the airflow. Her needs to be modified a little and it will be normal, otherwise it is some kind of strange shape. Place for landing turbine, I processed sandpaper. Now you can weld everything in a circle. I want to brag. I purchased a new welding helmet with excellent visibility. That feeling when you remove the protective film. A good mask is much more pleasant to work with. And once people cooked without a chameleon, sadness. Next, the airflow will go into the pipe. Now I will also sculpt and this element will be ready. The exhaust pipe has a larger diameter than the airflow outlet. Large and small pipes will not be interconnected. And why, I will show you a little later. I have already made various designs of unusual stoves. There is a glass oven in the workshop, a cool stuff turned out. The furnace generator works and actually generates electricity. Furnace with the principle of flame convection. You won't find this anywhere. Burner for the boiler, with some unrealistic power. Wood burning gas pyrolysis oven for camping. By the way, recently my wife and I went to our beloved Siberia for a few days. We tested the pyrolysis combustion ovina and cooked food in it. On pellets, of course, it burns longer and better, but it also works on ordinary wood. The beauty there is unimaginable, even our beast liked it there. And what sunsets there! And, of course, I didn't forget about you, I also answered comments there. I did a lot of different unusual designs of rocket stoves that you have not seen yet. For example, this one. It works on ordinary water. To be more precise, water is used in the combustion of fuel. An interesting law of physics is used here, called a jet pump. Jet thrust develops in a short pipe. See it with your own eyes. I also made rocket furnaces on other laws of physics. Ascending convection currents of air give an interesting effect when burning. There is no bottom and no lid in this furnace, and combustion takes place inside the pipe. It looks like a wood-burning forest stove. And also, based on the laws of physics, I made a high-power multi-fuel burner. It consists of just an ordinary twisted tube and various little things. All full videos on all my projects are already published on my channel. See, you will be interested. You can already assemble the main part of the furnace. A narrow pipe with forced airflow will be located directly opposite the outlet, and part of it does not go much into the exhaust pipe. Thus, a so-called jet pump is formed. Jet pump, a device for injection injector or suction ejector of liquid or gaseous substances, transportation of hydraulic mixtures, hydraulic elevator, the operation of which is based on the entrainment of the injected pumped out substance by a stream of liquid, steam or gas. Respectively differ water jet, steam jet and gas jet pumps. It is desirable to make everything airtight so that air is sucked in only from where need. I made the bottom out of 3 mm thick sheet. Of course, it would be nice to find stainless steel, or rather a mesh made of it with a suitable cell, but it was not. Decided to try to do it myself. I drew it under the grid, but changed my mind and made it great for the ashes. This will allow more air to enter and the ashes will fall on their own. Later it will be possible to make a separate container with adjustable intake air. Well, of course, I also didn't forget small lakes for convenience. To ignite the fuel, I ordered a candle a long time ago, which it is used in self-contained webasto-type furnaces operating on diesel fuel. The candle is designed for 12 volts. She heats up quickly enough, and by color you can understand what temperature it gives. I also make the upper part deaf, but with a viewing window. Through it I will lay fuel. Temporary, of course. In the future, if everything works out, it will simply be necessary to make the automatic supply of pellets by making a side sleeve, like in my glass stove for the workshop. Almost everything is finished. There are small touches left with which, as always, my homemade belt sander helps. I just adore him. This is such a beautiful lid. As they say, quality is in the details. She will be movable, of course it will most likely scratch, but we'll see. Now I will sculpt the cover in a circle, then I will paint it. Can you imagine? Degreaser smells of vanilla. Yes! Vanilla flavored degreaser. I will paint everything with heat resistant paint. It is up to 1000 degrees Celsius. I have never seen a higher temperature paint anywhere else. I think it she fits perfectly for this. It just makes me happy. It lays down perfectly. You don't need to paint 1000 layers. And the quality is the same. There are no splashes and smudges. There is no desire to repaint. Everything dried up quickly. And I already connected the electrician. Separate switch for the turbine. Separate switch for spark plug. I found a high voltage coil in my house to try to use in candle, but to be honest, it's somehow scary. That's it. I fall asleep fuel pellets and go outside to test. She stove works to heat a small room or even a tent. The principle of operation of the jet pump for exhaust gases came up to her. She doesn't need a tall vertical pipe for traction. A small piece lying horizontally on the ground is sufficient. Guys, if you like the video, like, subscribe, bell. Links to everything useful and interesting in the description under the video. Health and kindness to you and your loved ones. Thanks for watching this video. And see you on the channel. Bye.